Hey,
they don't know. They don't know what we got going on over here.
I'm not going to tell anybody, but I'm very impressed. I'm very impressed, BJ. BJ's doing a great job. Your team's on point.
Yeah, it's
everybody's doing their job.
It's a dope-ass camp.
There's a lot of things that Jake does very, very well.
Yeah.
We want to get him all the way around, better all the way around.
You know what I'm most impressed? You show him something and he picked it up like that.
He looks very coachable. So.
It's not normal.
He learns quick.
That's from wrestling.
Yeah.
That's what it was in wrestling. You know, you have to learn, listen to your coaches, and if a certain move is going to work, you got to do it right away. That's wrestling.
By the way, you have the float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, right?
Yeah.
What's the next tattoo?
I don't know.
Nate Robinson?
I was going to get Nothing Matters on my neck.
You can't hit with your eyes, you can't see, it's not supposed to go, but yeah.
Nothing matters? Why?
Nothing matters.
It doesn't matter.
It's kind of like...
Nothing faces it.
It's deeper than that, like... I don't know. No one cares about people until they die.
It's sad. And then they love you.
Yeah.
Then it's like... Every time it's... A big congratulations to Jake Paul and his team. Jake Paul just signed a promotional deal with Showtime. Showtime, of course, is the home of Gervonta Davis, the home of Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather is fighting Jake Paul on June 6th on Showtime. And if I was a guessing man, if I was a betting man, I'm saying it looks like Mayweather and Jake will fight next. Of course, has to get through Logan. But Mayweather fights on Showtime. Now Logan's on Showtime. Plus... the Bellator fighters, I thought Dylan Danis may be a Bellator fighter. Maybe it's easier to promote, easier to do. So a lot of options for him. There's a lot of boxing on Showtime. Who would have thought that Showtime, I mean, that was the home of Mike Tyson. And Jake Paul, you know, as I'm going to share with you a saying from Floyd Mayweather. Men lie, women lie, numbers don't lie. Jake Paul brings them numbers. And when he fights, when he boxes, people tune in. He's 3-0, 3 knockouts. Obviously, he knocked out Gibb. He knocked out Nate Robinson. We all saw that one. Shout out to Nate, by the way. And then his last fight, Ben Askren. And Ben Askren was a very accomplished fighter. Maybe not a boxer, but still a professional athlete in the highest level. Olympian, wrestler. And Jake was doing his thing. So let's see what is next. It's going to be big. Yesterday I spoke to Ali Abdelaziz, the manager of Usman. And he told me that Jake Paul beats Conor McGregor in a boxing match. And that he believes a fight with Usman definitely can happen. But he said the key is Dana White. If Dana White's on board, then it definitely can happen. So that's according to Ali Abdelaziz. But here's Jay Leon Love. There's BJ Flores. And there is, of course, Jake Paul. Jake Paul is always in shape. He's always training. And the move with Showtime is a very, very big move. Triller's great. They're doing their thing. But Showtime is more established, more mainstream. Showtime is obviously part of Viacom, Paramount. So a lot of options. And one thing I will tell you about Jake, he does train. Like it's not, I know a lot of influencers that are getting into boxing and they're not dedicated. They're doing it strictly for the money or doing it strictly just because it's cool for the moment. But Jake for the last 3 years has been extremely dedicated to boxing. He eats, sleeps, and drinks boxing. And that's what you have to do to make it in combat sport. You can't. It's not a part-time job. It's 24/7, 365. And it's not always fun. But last time he saw Floyd Mayweather, he grabbed Floyd Mayweather's hat and said, got your hat. And next thing he got the tattoo, got your hat tattoo. And the shirt, the hats, and everything. So stay tuned. We'll have much more on this on the deal with Showtime. There's BJ Flores. And we will see what is next. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Sekback. Reporting.
So it's like you wake up every single day and work and work and work and work and work and go and go and go and go and go and go and go. And then 500 years from now, I don't know, nothing really mattered that you did. Unless you like made the light bulb. So it reminds me to like do shit that can matter forever.
What makes you happy? By the way, KSI, is he ducking you too? He said it's a pandemic, he can't train.
Yeah.
But you did your research and in 5 minutes you found 10 gyms open?
I found 10 gyms open in London, but KSI is making the excuse that he can't train. His trainer said like, KSI, yeah.
Next.
I'm done, actually, you know what? I'm done talking about him. This is the last time I'm talking about KSI.
Done.
Yes, news.
All right, I'm done talking that's
about it. Him. He's done. He's done. Up.
Next. This is about being fighters, not talking about it.
Yeah, well, I mean, he had a good performance in Logan, and he could have correlated into something really good, which he chose not to, which, whatever, I respect it.
But people...
Going on. I get tired of people continually asking me about the fight with KSI and Jake. It's never going to happen.
Yeah.
I told Jake that last year.
But Jake, it's going to happen more and more. The more you win, the more challenging it will be to get fights. Am I right, BJ?
Yeah, of course. But not, KSI has another question already, because even Vidal, who is a boxing guy, is like, look, I'm not letting him fight Jake right now. His own guy is saying that. You think I would say that about Jake fighting KSI? Never. But Vidal, and he knows boxing. He had an amateur career. He knows what's up.
He's a professional. He's
like, I'm not putting him in with Jake right now. He's been training, sparring, and the word's out in Vegas already. People know that Jake can fight. So.
You know what's crazy? I did a poll on ES News. You and Ben Askren, like 150,000 people voted. Yeah. And it was like 55-45. They thought he was going to win. I'm like,
Perfect.
Yeah, that's great. Take it back, baby.
That's why it's a perfect fight.
I was shocked at that one.
Joe knows.
Beautiful day today. You got accomplished a lot. You worked hard. Jay Leon Love. Nicest guy in boxing.
One of them, yeah. Definitely one of them.
First time I met him, he was in camp with Margarito. He played the part of Manny Pacquiao.
Man, southpaw?
Yeah.
Man, I do it all, man. Southpaw.
Then he went. You went to Mexico with him. You were doing backflips in the mountains. Omar Henry got lost.
Yeah. Oh yeah, bro.
Omar Henry, remember him? He got lost in the mountains for like 8 hours in the middle of nowhere.
Almost like 30,000 feet, bro. You couldn't even breathe. So if you wasn't used to the run, you was getting left behind, bro. These motherfuckers run like horses.
So, and some guy got lost?
Bro, we got lost, bro. And Tony Marie was about to get a helicopter and sail over the mountains, bro.
Shit.
Bro, he was gone for hours, bro. And we just stayed out there looking for him, bro. And we went about an hour into the mountain, bro. Somehow he just was out there. But if the night
you
hit...
You found him?
Yes. If the night would have hit, he would have been eaten up, bro.
Right. Yeah. It was cold as fuck, too.
You got your whole team.
I don't know what's up.
Your whole team boxing now?
They're getting after
it. I was even in there 2 weeks.
How was it?
It was interesting.
Marcos is good. You got natural talent.
If you got in a street fight, hypothetically, not that you get a street fight, which one of your team members is on speed dial to come right away? Like, who would be there first?
I mean, these three.
But we don't street fight. You know?
No. You know, you're professional.
We get paid to fight.
You're a professional.
I'll be there regardless.
We're private security. Our private security won't allow a street fight. We say no to street fights.
Yeah, we have full-time security anyways.
That's good. That's very important.
I don't.
Why?
He's
you
like,
don't need
rob me. Someone come rob me.
No, I'm not like that, but I mean, I'm not waiting for no security.
Girl, what's up?
But he's right there.
Let's go, man.
He's working.
We don't have to wait that long. It's like 2 seconds.
But Jay, you've improved leaps and bounds. Every time I see you, you're like 30, 40, 50% better. 50% better.
Bro, that's hard work. It's showing up every day. No excuses. And I really want this. I really want this.
Can you compare it to anything else you did in life where you learned and it...
I compare it to wrestling, you know? Like, the first year you start wrestling, you get beat up. Then the second year, you're good. Then the third year, you start to get the hang of it. And you're like, wow, I love this. And then from there, it just exponentially grows. You know, I won the award on my wrestling team for the hardest worker. And I don't take that lightly. And I started out my first year, I was like okay on the team. And by my last year of wrestling, I was the best on the team by far. So I just always like to improve.
And now look at you. One of the biggest names in boxing, whether people love you or not, it's a fact.
Yeah.
Pay-per-view, number 8 all time, 7 all time?
Number 8 pay-per-view buys all time.
And now Mike Tyson is Uncle Mike to you?
Yeah.
I asked him about you and Connor. Did you see the video when I asked him,
no,
you and Connor? He said, I said, Jake a fight. He goes, Connor can too. What do you think?
What was the question?
Him and Connor, what do you think?
already said what I think.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, Conor's a great champion. Obviously a massive name, and we think we beat him, so we'll run the one there and put it to test.
That's true.
We'll be in.
But the only thing is, if there was no pandemic, Jake, I think you would have a big impact on boxing. I think every gym would be packed with your fans trying to learn how to box because you're introducing them to a sport that they didn't follow before.
Yeah, to like the young kids.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
That's my goal, is to get like hundreds of thousands of kids to box. And people like to say, oh, Jake Paul's not doing or is bad for the sport. What he's doing is bad for the sport. If someone says that, they're an old fucking paid-ass loser and they can suck the nearest dick, in my opinion. Because I'm bringing a whole new audience to boxing. A whole new audience. I have 50 million followers that are starting to pay attention to boxing.
You're right.
That helps everyone in boxing because they'll watch me, then they'll become, you know, a fan of someone else. They'll become a fan of Benavidez. They'll become a fan of Joshua. They'll become a fan of Fury.
They'll start training themselves in the sport.
Exactly. And they start to learn about this sport. They start to care. And they start to spend money, and boxing grows, and everyone's happier.
You're right.
So, yeah, I don't know how someone can really hate, but
you know,
I've never hated on anyone in my life, so I don't understand.
I'm gonna tell you.
We gotta go to another gym and know about.
Let me tell you what Kobe Bryant said once. Embrace the haters.
Yep.
They don't hate the good ones. They hate the great ones.
Yeah.
Just think about that. Like, if you're okay. If you're struggling, people love you.
Yeah.
If you're doing okay, they tolerate. But if you're doing great, they hate you. It's with a passion. And your haters are your biggest fans. They watch you more than anyone.
Yeah. They're always.
They live on your page.
Paying attention, commenting on shit. I love it. I love everything about this life. So, just to start.
Yeah, but it's great.